Hi, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. I got asked how to use speed curve as background. So with this video, I'm going to show you how you can create audio edit like this. Now let's get started. First, open CapCut with the video that has the music you want. You can skip this step if you did not import your music from audio. As you can see here, I import the music from audio. If you want to learn how to add music on CapCut, you can check out my last video. When you import music as audio, let's click on it. You can see you only can change the speed at a constant pace. But if you want to use curve speed, you want to make sure export your music as a video first. Let's click on export. Then click on new project to open the video we just export. Now you can use the curve speed to edit. However, this song is more than 2 minutes, but I don't want to use that whole song, so I'm going to trim it down to the part that I want. So you can get to the part that you want. Click on the clip. You can click on split to split out the part that you don't want. You might wonder, what if I have multiple parts of the video? For example, you have 2 parts. You also want to export this as a whole video before you use the curve function. Then click on new project again to open the clip that we trim out. Now you can click on the clip, click on speed, click on curve, double click on costume. Now you can edit your video. If you want the video to be slower, then you move it downward. If you want it to be faster, then you would move it upward. You can also add beat at the part that you want. Just move this to the part where you want to add the beat. You can click on add beat and then move that to however you like. After you are done, you want to screen record this part. For iPhone, I can screen record directly, but for Android, you might need to download a screen recording app. If you are using iPhone, then you want to make sure you click on the screen recording button. Since I'm recording a tutorial here, I'm not going to stop it. After you put the screen record on, then you would play the song.
Don't wake me, I'm not dreaming.
Then you want to stop the recording after you finish. Then you can exit out this one. Click on new project to open the screen recording. For me, I did one previously. So click on it. Then trim out the part you don't need. You can click on split and then delete the part that you don't need. Now click on the clip. Click on edit, then you want to click on crop, click on 16:9, then select the part that you want to keep, which is the curve speed part. Now you want to go to format, then select 16:9. So that's how you can use this as a background. You might wonder, what if I want to use it with other video or pictures? Well, you can just click on the plus icon. Then select the picture or video that you want to use. Then go back to the first one, click on overlay, click on the clip, then click on overlay again to move it to the overlay track. Now click on the overlay clip again, click on splice. If you want to remove the black background, you can click on filter. But if you want to keep the black background, you can also adjust the opacity to how you like it. Then you can click on effects to add in any effects that you like. If you want the effect for the main video, then you can leave it, but if you want to use it on the overlay, then you can click on the object, then select overlay. You can also adjust the picture or video to match the clip. You can have multiple effects if you want, just add whatever you like. So that's how you can use the curve speed as a background and add effects to it. If you found this video to be helpful, please consider like, subscribe, and comment down below. As always, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.